Eve Arnold shot this lovely group of people during a black Muslim rally in Washington, D.C. in 1961, head of the American Nazi Party. Unlikely guest at a Malcolm X event. Eve died last week, 99 years old. The images are part of her collection, and they hang in the Saatchi Gallery, marking the Sun Times magazine's 50th anniversary. I'm Bernie Gobach. I'm not in that magazine. I'm in my back garden in Castro County, Tipperary, Ireland, giving you an American's view of the Sunday news in Ireland. Windy day. We'll see how it goes. I live over on www.insideview.ie, my blog. I also tweet a topgold. Front page story has a photo of Laura Dekker, 16 years old, from the Netherlands, and Sunday Times sailing forth from St. Martin in the Caribbean. She's going to try to do, or has done, around the world in 16, at the age of 16. She's done 27,000 miles solo voyage. I just couldn't imagine sending a daughter on that, letting a daughter do that. Hey, I don't have to wait long for this, though. It's a levy that's going to hit 10% of top earners. Sarah McInerney has a story. It's all part of austerity in Ireland. A review of the universal social charge basically means this. It means workers at certain pay grades could get a pay rise but suffer a cut in net pay by crossing a threshold. What's happening where I work is some people going back to about 3 or 4 day work week with flexi time, so they don't hit that universal social charge threshold. It is happening now. They're on a reduced work week, but if this comes into effect, some pretty creative people I work with aren't going to go to a full week work week. Here's a ripoff. Mark Tye points it out. In Poland, if you want to go to the games, the Euro 2012 games in Gdansk, well, and you're Irish, and you're going to watch the playoff, you're going to discover that Polish hotels there are charging up to 24 times their normal rate during Euro 2012. Normal kind of a thing. Inside this paper are some things I'm calling long reads. That's the first one. Hi, I'm the guy who blacked out the world. Jimmy Wales is the story. It's a story about Jimmy Wales. Camilla Long writes about his perspective on shutting down the internet using the Stop Online Piracy Act and the Protect Intellectual Property Act of the United States Congress. Wales was one of many that wanted to oppose the bills. Pretty harsh if you look at what the technologies were going to be doing to stop people from allegedly violating copyright. Thank God both of the acts are currently tabled. Doesn't mean they won't come back. Mark Tye has a story that's inside the paper, is another long read. Student is shocked by love hate, by web hate. Basically, the student's name is Owen McHugh, 22 years old. Took an action in the Irish High Court on Saturday, trying to block six papers from naming him. Sunday Times did name him, Irish Times didn't. The judge who heard the case says, look, I understand your distress that people misidentified you as a culprit, as a taxi fare evader, but newspapers aren't responsible for other people's comments. It's right. Poor guy's caught up in something that a long read will tell you about later on. Tougher pension rules could cut entitlement, Sarah McInerney warns. And what's happening is the full blow payout for a pensioner in the future in Ireland is only going to be paid if you have 30 years of PRSI contributions. That will affect me. So I will have worked in Ireland for more than 20 years, but will not get the full pension if the rule kicks in. Here's an interesting idea. An American Taliban seeks an Irish passport. Owen Reynolds writes the story. Hey, he's part of the diaspora. He was also terrorist number one, had to sign a statement, meaning he wasn't going to talk about the details of torture by U.S. troops. He is Irish, two generations from being an Irishman. His parents are, of course, troubled by what happened to him. Converted to Islam, went to Afghanistan, fought, ended up shooting at Americans. Americans don't like being shot at. This Bailey witness, Marie Farrell, who once said that Ian Bailey was on a bridge near a home where there was a murder, says that she made up the statement, and if she was called by the French, she would explain that that happened. Sunday Times seems to be on Ian Bailey's side, which is all right. I mean, I actually think the man's got no case to answer, but that's just a personal opinion. The storyline keeps following, keeps blowing, and the decision hasn't been made yet whether he's going to be extradited to France. Legally, it looks like he won't, based on some documents the French gave the Irish. Do not disturb, the headline says, loners do the best work. An article written by Margaret Driscoll cites something which I consider a long read about creativity. And what she does, she explains a new book published in America by Susan Cain, which says that quiet, the power of introverts in a world that can't stop talking, spirit of defense of people that need to slink away and do work in quiet, actually get stuff done. Hey, look, this is The Nationalist, which has a long read, a longer read, about the Clonmel couple, Seamus and Carol Moore, at their home in Clonmel. They survived that sinking of that ship. The long read inside the Sunday Times is just as interesting. It's called The Showboater, written by John Follain in Porto San Stefano, and talks about the captain and his proclivities. The fact, as I pointed out in audioboo.fm/topgold, he's actually using line of sight to just to weave his way through the small channel between an island and the main Italian coast. And when he did it, he ended up hitting a rock. He was well off a route that was approved by the agency owning the boat. Pretty interesting stuff. Lots of damage to his own personal reputation. But, you know, as the tidbits come out about the man himself, you'd wonder how much courage he had as a captain. Off to See the Markets is another story, a long read, number 4 of 8, I'd say. Brian Carey says, you know, Ireland's being really nice, a success story, a poster child, but what's happening in the meantime are lots of things involving austerity, real cuts, home help, nursing homes closing, special needs assistance that are being struck off the rolls, pain-inflicted society, all around the front page, reminding John Hanlon, who runs Study Products, a container company, that, look, Eastern Europe had the same problem in the year 2000. Very little hope, stagnant economy, people are riddled with fear, and when you have the local economy so downtrodden, you can't dig yourself out of the hole. Here's the long read story called Tangled on the Web by Mark Tye. It's about your man, Ellen McHugh. You can decide, is he in the film? The taxi cam runs in the front seat of the cab. Students are deciding what to do. They make a choice. Some of them jump out of the cab early. And the front seat passenger, who is alleged on Facebook to be Owen, does a runner roll. Now, in the original video, there was a still photograph posted of Owen, perhaps taken from his Facebook page, and that's what caused all the stink. People are saying, yeah, that is Owen in the photo, but actually it may not have been, it shouldn't have been Owen in the actual taxi cam. Big issues, though, about, you know, whether he can actually sue Facebook to the ends of the earth like he's trying to. Might not be worth the trouble. Long read, though. You can decide yourself. Hey, art. I love art. I'm content is what it says in the neon. Undertow is what the project is called, a curated project by Aideen Barry and Alice Marr. 11 participants, 132 submissions for an art space in Limerick. And it's at Ormston House in Limerick. We'll probably go there with a group of students in the exhibition program. I tag it on Twitter as LITEX for exhibition. An exhibition is behind the pool we hope we're going to have for another hashtag, LIT Animation, LIT Annie. Kathy Pulley writes a story in the education pages saying, brush up on the art of application, and she advises that if you're going to go to an arts course, like our animation course, there's a restriction placed on the central admissions office where you need to be presenting a portfolio and an interview. So that complicates issues if you're going to come on the animation degree, but makes it all worthwhile. Proposed broadcasting charge needs debating. I call it the RTE bailout tax. So households are going to get automatically billed for the charge, probably less than 160 euro that we currently pay for the broadcast fee, just because we can watch RT across the internet using gadgets. Yes, we do. These are gadgets called Gadget Fix in the in-gear section of Sunday Times. I like these things, like the shirt shuffle. So I'm going to put this into my blog as something I want for 43 euro. Pack up a shirt really nicely. And I like, I'm officially putting on my wish list, a camera, a pocket-sized camera with interchangeable lenses. I need that. So does Mia, the 3-year-old. She likes taking photos. She's doing photo shots with the Xperia Arc right now, and is doing well. Better sales are just a text away, says Sandra O'Connell. And it's a story about Kiarna Flynn, who runs Copen in Lerath Mines. QR codes help build responses. And what's interesting, what was really interesting to me, is that the total produce introduced on-pack QR codes. Very surprising results. The company found people really like to use the QR codes to go over to a video and look, learn how to cut your melon so it looks like a flower. No amount of market research would tell you that so many people are interested in such rich media interaction with their phones, with QR codes. The bottom of the page, of the comments page, an article by Barry McCarth talking about the points race. I'm going to raise this issue under the tag innovation with my games developers in LIT. Ireland's now ranked below average in maths. These guys had to have above average skills in maths to be on that software development course leading to a degree in games development. Interesting stuff. Ireland's still toward, Ireland's going down in regards to maths capability in second level schools. The Secrets of Living to 100, a long read. New research into the role of genes and aging offers a perspective of preventive medicine. Rosie Kitchen has a story, interesting stuff here, about the full genome is currently more expensive than most people can afford, but California company Life Technology says they can sequence the whole genome for under €1,000. I'm interested in that. Really interested in that. I think you should be interested in this, a long read about the Internet Pirate King clamped into irons. Look at this.
Let's do it. Let's rock and roll.
We have just been stopped by the Moroccan police. I gave him 100 euro and another 50 euro, and I made a deal with him that he will stop the black Porsche for 10 minutes.
What? How? This is him.
Yeah.
I told them to stop him for 10 minutes. You saw me? These guys are challenging me. And I show you now what I'm doing with guys that are challenging me. I bump them in the back. Boom. Boom.
Mohammed, do they have good hospitals in Morocco?
No, they don't at all.
Mohammed, do they have rescue helicopters in Morocco?
No, they don't.
Well then, this is the first time I fasten my seatbelt.
He's out racing in the cannonball. Tony Allen Mills points out scenes worthy of a Bond film unfolded when police raided the New Zealand mansion. I took away his pink Cadillac. 72-page indictment that you can find over on insideview.ie, accusing Mega Upload of a conspiracy. Conspiracies are action words in the United States. This record is going to have him by the shorts, Harry. Okay, a quick walk around the back garden to look at stuff. Simply, I'd like to know, why am I getting weeds out of my bird feeder? It's a question for the sod show. Now back inside.
Chew.
Oh, then to me, play your voice and daddy, I need to.
Mia has more interesting things in my video. And that's all I have from here in the back garden of Cashel County, Tipperary, Ireland. It's Bernie Goldbach, the American in Ireland, with his long reads for Sunday. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.